Water disruptions, with most of those under a boil water notice. Even hospitals are struggling to maintain water pressure. In Galveston, most residents have no power or heat. The local medical examiner setting up a refrigerated truck outside its building, anticipating an influx of deaths. The county's judge, furious.
Everyone knew this was coming. We had at least a week's advance notice, so I'm very upset.
The Electric Reliability Council of Texas, also known as ERCOT, under fire for the power outages. The company said on Wednesday it restored power to more than 1 million households. Texas Governor Greg Abbott has called for an investigation and for the company's executives to resign. But Abbott himself is under fire, critics accusing him of deflecting responsibility by placing blame on renewable energy sources.
This shows how the Green New Deal would be a deadly deal for the United States of America.
Changing his tune just hours later.
The companies that generate the power, their operations have frozen up or have tripwired and are non-operational. That is the lead reason why there is a shortage of power.
Beto O'Rourke disagrees.
Our renewable energy portfolio actually outperformed the forecast. Regardless of what, you know, Greg Abbott and other Republicans and right-wing media are saying.
And the rolling blackouts are expected to continue throughout the day. In this neighborhood, someone told me they were 3 hours on, 8 hours off. They're expected to get shorter, but at the moment, they don't have any guarantees, Kate.
Oh, that's the worst part of it. Camila, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Because of this, just coming into CNN right now, Senator Ted Cruz, he is now facing a whole lot of questions after he was spotted on a plane traveling to Cancun, Mexico, in the midst of this unfolding crisis in his home state of Texas. CNN's Jessica Dean, she has the details on this. She's joining me right now from Capitol Hill. Jessica, what are you hearing about this?
Well, good morning to you, Kate. We have confirmed what multiple social media users posted photos of, and that is that Texas Senator Ted Cruz and his family traveled to Cancun, Mexico, while all of this is going on in his home state. Of course, multiple social media users posted photos of, and that is that Texas Senator Ted Cruz and his family traveled to Cancun, Mexico, while all of this is going on in his home state. Of course, he is elected to represent and advocate for these millions of people who right now are without power, without water, without groceries, as you all just laid out right there. We do know that Senator Cruz did travel to Mexico. Now, we've also confirmed with a source familiar with his itinerary plans that he is booked on a return flight to Houston for today, but who's to say if he gets on that flight? We, of course, don't know until that actually happens. But that is certainly the case right now. One Texas state representative, Gene Wu, tweeting that Cruz is traveling while the state was freezing to death and having to boil water. So it is certainly dire circumstances in his home state of Texas as Senator Cruz travels to Cancun, Mexico with his family. Again, right now, the Senate is out. They are on recess, so they are obviously not here doing any work at the Capitol. He had traveled home, and we now know that he had traveled to Mexico while this humanitarian crisis is unfolding in his home state. Kate.